everyone. In this video, I am going to discuss about the chest examination findings in pulmonary problems. Here, this is Julian K. Thomas, faculty OT, Edgecliff College of Nursing. The objectives of the presentation include: the group should be able to identify abnormal chest examination findings related to various respiratory problems. A respiratory examination or lung examination is performed as a part of physical examination in response to respiratory symptoms such as shortness of breath, cough or chest pain. So the main elements of respiratory assessment include thorough history collection, physical examination and other investigations related to respiratory system. So the four main techniques of the respiratory examinations include inspection, palpation, percussion and auscultations of the respiratory sounds. So a focused assessment is used to evaluate the status of previously identified any respiratory problems and also to monitor for signs of any new problems which is related to the respiratory system. The common respiratory disorders include chronic obstructive disorders, asthma, pneumonia, atelectasis, pulmonary edema, pleural effusion and pulmonary fibrosis. So in this video, I am going to discuss about the common respiratory examination findings related to these respiratory disorders. First, we will see about chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, it is also known as COPD. So it is an obstructive disease of the airway or the respiratory system. So the COPD, it consists of two disease conditions, that is chronic bronchitis and emphysema. Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease or COPD, which refers to chronic bronchitis and emphysema, a pair of two commonly coexisting diseases of the lungs in which the airways become narrow. So bronchitis, which results from inflammation of bronchi leading to increased mucus production, cough and eventual scarring of the bronchial lining. So it is also defined as the presence of cough and sputum production for at least 3 consecutive months. Continuously for 3 months, if the patient is having the presence of cough and sputum, then we can define it as a bronchitis. The risk factors for COPD includes cigarette smoking, occupational dust and chemicals, environmental tobacco smoke, indoor and outdoor air pollution. So any of these can lead to COPD. The chest examination findings of COPD, that is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, includes: in inspection, we can identify there is a change in the shape of the chest due to repeated hyperresponsiveness and inflammation of the airway. The patient will get a barrel shaped chest. And cyanosis, that is bluish discoloration of the skin due to decreased oxygenation to the tissues. And very often the patient will assume tripod position, that is leaning forward because of respiratory distress, and there will be use of accessory muscles. So these are the changes we can identify in inspection. And in palpation, we can see there will be a decreased chest movement. And in percussion, there will be hyper-resonant or dull sound if there is consolidation in the lung tissues. So if consolidation is present, we can percuss and hear either dull sound or otherwise there will be hyper-resonant sound. On auscultations, there will be crackles, bronchi or wheeze. So distinct sounds can be identified during auscultation. So these are the abnormal chest findings we can identify for a patient with chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. The next respiratory disorder includes asthma. Asthma is a chronic inflammatory disease of the airway. There will be hyper-responsiveness of the airway, mucosal edema and mucus production. So asthma is a disorder of the bronchial airways characterized by a period of reversible bronchospasm. The causes of asthma include any allergens such as like pet dander, or if the person is having any stress, certain medications also can induce asthma, dust allergy, chemicals and perfumes, air pollution, smoking, any genetic factors, because asthma can be transferred from one generation to another generation, or any respiratory infections if not treated well that can lead into asthma, or some food and beverages. So some of the allergic agents or some disease conditions or genetic factors also can contribute to asthma. The chest examination findings for asthma include, if the patient is not in exacerbation, all the findings, that is inspection, palpation and percussion and auscultation, the findings will be normal in case of if the patient is not in exacerbation. But if the asthma, if the patient is having exacerbation of asthma, in inspection we can see there will be prolonged expiration. So the expiration will be prolonged and the patient will assume a tripod position and pursed lip breathing can be seen in inspection. And in palpation there will be decreased chest movement, and in percussion hyper resonant sound can be heard while percussing the chest wall. And in auscultation there will be wheeze and there will be decreased breath sound. So these are obvious signs when there is a severely diminished air movement in the chest. So these are some of the chest examination findings related to asthma. Next, respiratory disorder into pneumonia. Pneumonia, it is an inflammatory process in the lung parenchyma usually associated with a marked increase in interstitial and the alveolar fluid. So due to an inflammation of the lung parenchyma, there will be collection of fluid in the interstitial space as well as the alveolar. So the causes of this pneumonia can be either bacteria or virus or fungi or any aspiration of the food agents. The chest examination findings of pneumonia includes, in inspection we can see tachypnea, so there will be increased respiratory rate for the patient, use of accessory muscles due to respiratory distress, and duskiness or cyanosis, there will be bluish discoloration of the skin due to decreased oxygenation to the tissues. And in palpation in the chest wall we can see increased tactile fremitus over the affected area, which side of the lung is affected, so that side there will be increased fremitus. In percussion there will be dullness over the affected areas. And in auscultation, in early stages of pneumonia we can hear the bronchial sounds, and in the later stages of pneumonia we can hear crackles, rogging, egophony, whispered pectoral. So these are some of the abnormal birth sounds we can hear during pneumonia. So these are some of the abnormal chest examination findings related to pneumonia. The next respiratory disorder include atelectasis. Atelectasis is a condition in which one or more areas of the lungs collapse or it doesn't inflate properly. So as a result of atelectasis, fresh air does not reach to the alveoli and the oxygen and the carbon dioxide cannot be exchanged properly. So it can lead to hypoxia and many other complications related to respiratory problems. The reason for atelectasis include a blocked airway, that is obstructive causes, or a pressure from outside of the lung that can be non-obstructive. So the causes can either be obstructive or non-obstructive. The obstructive causes of atelectasis includes any mucus plug in the respiratory tract, any foreign body, that is atelectasis is common in children who have inhaled any object such as peanut or a small toy pop into their lungs. Or the other reason can be a tumor in the major airway, abnormal growth can narrow the airway, and a blood clot in the pulmonary circulation. These are some of the obstructive reasons for atelectasis or collapse of the lungs. Non-obstructive causes of atelectasis include injury, that is any chest trauma from a fall or a car accident, or either pleural effusion or a pneumonia. Different types of pneumonia or any infection of the lungs can cause a temporarily atelectasis. Pneumothorax, then tumor, a large tumor which can press against the lung, which will prevent the lungs to deflate. So these are some of the non-obstructive causes of atelectasis. The chest examination findings of atelectasis include, in inspection there will not be any obvious changes we can identify unless a large segment of the lobe is involved. There will not no change unless involves entire segment of the lobe. And in palpation, if there is small, no change. If the atelectasis or the collapse is large, there will be decreased movement of the chest and there will be decreased fremitus over the affected area. And in percussion, there will be dullness over the affected area. Auscultation, crackles can be heard or absent breath sounds if there is a large atelectasis. So these crackles can be disappear with when the patient takes deep breath, the crackles can be disappear. So crackles or either there will be absence of blood cells depends upon the severity of the atelectasis. Next, respiratory disorder include pulmonary edema. Pulmonary edema is a condition in which there will be abnormal buildup of fluids in the lung tissues. So this buildup of fluid leads to shortness of the breath. As there is an increased collection of fluid in the lung parenchyma, so there will be difficulty in breathing for the patients. The reasons for pulmonary edema include congestive cardiac failure, heart attack, cardiomyopathy, leaking or narrowed heart valves, either mitral or aortic valves, sudden severe high blood pressure. Certain medicines also can lead to pulmonary edema, high altitude exposure, kidney failure, narrow arteries that bring blood to the kidneys, lung damage caused by poisonous gas or severe infection, and major injury. These are some of the reasons where patients can develop with pulmonary edema. The chest examination findings of pulmonary edema includes, in inspection there will be tachypnea, increased to respiratory rate, labored respirations or cyanosis, bluish discoloration of the skin due to decreased oxygenation to the tissues. In palpation there will be decreased chest movement or normal movement of the chest. In percussion there will be dull or normal depending upon the amount of the fluid present in the lung parenchyma. And in auscultation we can hear fine or coarse crackles at the base, which is moving upward as the condition worsens. When the pulmonary edema becomes worse, the sound, the fine crackles or the coarse crackles, which moves from base to upwards. Next, respiratory condition involved the pleural effusion. Pleural effusion is a condition in which there will be collection of fluid in the pleural space. So that is the space between the visceral and the parietal pleura. That is a rarely primary disease process, but it is usually secondary to other respiratory disorders also. So the pleural space normally contains only about 10 to 20 ml of serous fluid. When this fluid becomes excess, then leads to pleural effusion. Pleural fluid normally seeps continuously into the pleural space from the capillaries lining the parietal pleura and is reabsorbed by the visceral pleural capillaries and the lymphatic system. When this system is altered, which leads to collection of fluid in the pleural space, that can lead to pleural effusion. Any condition that interferes with either secretion or drainage of this fluid leads to pleural effusion. The pleural effusions can be classified into two types, that is transudative effusions and exudative effusion. Transudative effusions are also known as hydrotherapies, occur primarily in non-inflammatory conditions, that is it is simply an accumulation of low protein or low cell content fluid. But in case of exudative effusion, this effusion occur in areas of inflammation and this is an accumulation of high protein fluid. The causes of transudative effusion includes when there is an increase in the hydrostatic pressure when found in heart failure, that is the most common reason for transudative effusion, or decrease in the oncotic pressure from hypoalbuminemia, it is found in cirrhosis of liver or renal disease. So these are the causes of transudative effusion. In this condition, the fluid movement is facilitated out of the capillaries and into the pleural space. The causes of exudative effusions include disseminated cancer, particularly the lung and the breast or the lymphoma, pleuropulmonary infections, example is pneumonia, or heart failure, cirrhosis or nephrotic syndrome, and other conditions such as sarcoidosis or systemic lupus erythematosus, SLE, and peritoneal dialysis also can lead to exudative type of effusions. In exudative type, the protein content will be more. The chest examination findings in pleural effusions include, in inspection we can see tachypnea and use of accessory muscles due to respiratory distress. And in palpation there will be increased movement of the chest wall, increased fremitus over the effusion area, and there will be sometimes absent fremitus over the effusion region. And in percussion we can hear a dull sound, and in auscultation there will be diminished or absent breath sounds over the effusion area. An egophony over the effusion area can be heard. The next respiratory problem include pulmonary fibrosis. So pulmonary fibrosis is a condition in which the lung tissues is replaced by fibrous tissues due to repeated inflammations of the lung parenchyma. It may be the result of inflammatory process. The volume is reduced and the texture of the lung parenchyma is altered. So ventilation does not take place in the fibrosed region. The examination findings in pulmonary fibrosis shows inspection there will be increased respiratory rate, that is tachypnea, and in palpation there will be decreased chest movement, and in percussion there will be normal findings, and in auscultation crackles or the sound like velcro being pulled apart. So that sound can be heard during auscultation. So these are some of the common respiratory disorders and chest examination findings related to the particular disorder. So to conclude that the ability to carry out and document a full respiratory assessment is an essential skill for all nurses. The nurses should develop competent knowledge and skills in identifying the abnormal chest findings related to respiratory conditions to avoid further complications for the patient. Physical examination helps us to find out the objective data or signs to confirm the diagnosis. A prompt initial assessment allows immediate evaluation of severity of illness, and appropriate treatment measures may warrant instigation at this point. These are the references. Thank you for your patient listening.